Hello everyone, welcome back. This is the third lecture on the impact of jet on veins. In this lecture, we will continue our discussion on the impact of jet on a moving curved vein. At the end of this lecture, you will be able to apply impulse momentum principle to analyze the work done by a jet on a curved vein and to calculate the efficiency of the jet. Accordingly, in this lecture, I will be talking about how to apply impulse momentum principle to calculate the work done and the efficiency of a jet when impinging on a moving curved vein. Before we start the topic, let us quickly glance through what we have discussed so far. We have seen that a jet of fluid is a stream of fluid which is coming out from a nozzle with a very high velocity, and if an object is kept along the path of this jet, the jet exerts a force on the object which is known as the impact of the jet. This is a hydrodynamic force, which is the force exerted by a moving stream of liquid, and hence it can be analyzed by using the impulse momentum principle, which can be stated as impulsive force is equal to the rate of change of momentum. And this we have seen when applied to a curved vein, the impact of jet on a smooth and frictionless curved vein when held stationary along the path of the jet, and if the vein is symmetrical about the axis of the jet, the force exerted by the jet on the vein along the x and y directions are given by fx is equal to rho a v square into 1 plus cos theta and fy is equal to 0. In this case, the x direction is taken as the direction of flow of the jet and y direction is perpendicular to that. And also in this expression, rho is the mass density of the fluid and A is the cross-sectional area of the jet, B is the velocity of the jet, and theta is the angle of the vein. Here you can see theta, which makes the jet gets deflected through an angle 180 minus theta. If this vein is moving with a velocity u along the direction of the jet, in that case we have to consider the relative velocity with which the jet is striking the vein. In this case, since v, the velocity of the jet, and the velocity of the vein u are in the same direction, the relative velocity with which the jet is striking the vein is given by v minus u, and this expression for force is written in terms of the relative velocity as fx is equal to rho a into v minus u whole square into 1 plus cos theta and fy is equal to 0. This is what we have discussed so far. This expression for force can also be written as fx is equal to gamma by g into a into v minus u whole square into 1 plus cos theta, where gamma is the specific weight of the fluid, which can be written as a product of mass density and acceleration due to gravity, that is gamma is equal to rho into g. Now let us see the concept of work done. Say you have an object and assume that this is the positive x direction and this is the positive y direction, and a force is acting on the object along the positive x direction, and assume that under the action of the force, the object gets displaced through a distance d. In that case, the work done by this force on this body along the x direction is given by this force multiplied by this displacement d. However, you can also have cases when this force and displacement are not in the same direction. Like for example, the force is inclined at some angle to the x-axis. So in this case, this force can be resolved into components along the x and y direction. Say fx is the x component and fy is the y component. Using these components of the force f along the x and y direction, we can calculate the work done along the x and y direction. So in this case, if you want to calculate the work done by this force F along the x direction, it is equal to the component of force along the x direction multiplied by the displacement along the x direction. It is Fx into D. Similarly, work done along the y direction is given by the component of force along the y direction Fy multiplied by displacement along the y direction. In this case, since the displacement is purely along the x direction, along the y direction it is zero, therefore the work done along the y direction becomes zero. In short, what I mean to tell here is we can calculate the work done as the force into the displacement, force into displacement in the same direction, or we can also say that work done per unit time is given by force into displacement per unit time. We have this component displacement per unit time, which is nothing but the velocity of the body or velocity with which the object is moving, and this work done per unit time is nothing but the power, or we can say that the power developed in this case is equal to the force into the velocity, or work done in any direction is equal to force into velocity in that direction. This concept can be extended to find the work done by a jet when it impinges on a curved vane which is moving with a velocity u, as we have seen earlier. So we have seen the work done per unit time or power generated by this jet is given by force into velocity with which the vane is moving, and this can be calculated along the x and y direction. Therefore, along the x direction, the work done, that is w subscript x, x stands for the x direction, is given by, when I say work done, it is understood that we are talking about the work done per unit time. Therefore, work done per unit time along the x direction is given by the component of force along the x direction fx multiplied by the velocity of the vane along the x direction, that is u. We have seen earlier that fx is equal to rho a into v minus u whole square into 1 plus cos theta. So that multiplied by u gives the work done along the x direction. The same thing can be extended for y direction. So work done along the y direction is given by the component of force along the y direction multiplied by velocity of the vane along the y direction. In this case, since the jet is purely in the horizontal direction and we have seen that there is no force acting along the y direction, Fy is 0, and also the vane is moving purely along the x direction. Therefore, the velocity component along the y direction is also 0. So both Fy and the velocity components are 0 in this case, which makes the work done along the y direction as 0. I have already mentioned that this work done per unit time is the power generated. So when this jet impinges on this curved vane, this is the power generated or the output power produced. To generate this output power, what is the input power that is going into a system? We know that this is a case of a jet coming out from a nozzle. In this case, the jet is under atmospheric pressure. Therefore, there is no pressure force or no pressure energy available to the jet. So the only energy available to the jet at this point is the kinetic energy, which is due to its mass and velocity. And we know the expression for kinetic energy, that is half mv square. As in the case of output power, which we calculated per unit time, here input kinetic energy also we determine per unit time. Therefore, we need to see what is the input kinetic energy per unit time, that is half mv square per unit time. Here we can write it as half into mass per unit time into the square of the velocity. This mass per unit time is the mass flow rate, which we have already seen that can be represented as rho into area into velocity. Rho is the mass density of the fluid, A is the cross-sectional area of the jet, and V is the velocity of the jet. This gives you the mass flow rate, that is mass flowing per unit time multiplied by the square of the velocity, which gives you the expression for kinetic energy as input kinetic energy is half rho A into V cube. Thus, we have seen both output work done per unit time or output power produced by the jet and the input energy available to the jet. Knowing these two, let us discuss what is the efficiency of the jet. You know that efficiency is equal to output power divided by input power. What is the output power produced by the jet that we have seen as work done per unit time, that is fx into u, that is rho a into v minus u whole square into 1 plus cos theta into u, and input power is the input kinetic energy per unit time, that is half rho a v cube, And if we substitute and simplify this expression, we will get efficiency of the jet in this case, eta is equal to 2u into v minus u whole square into 1 plus cos theta divided by v cube, where u is the velocity of the jet, velocity of the wave, u is the velocity of, v is the velocity of the jet and theta is the vane angle. That means the efficiency is a function of velocity of the vane u, velocity of the jet v and the vane angle theta. Now consider a case where a constant jet is coming and impinging on a curved vane, which means that the jet is constant, its area does not change, velocity does not change, area and velocity are constant, characteristics of the jet remains constant. And a vane is given to you, which means that you know the theta of the vane. So given the velocity of the jet v, given the vane angle theta, then what is not known to you is u. So you can see by changing u, the speed with which the vane is moving, you can adjust the efficiency. So what is the value of u which will help you to attain maximum efficiency in this case? Since only variable is u in this case, the maximum efficiency we can determine if you take the first derivative of this efficiency expression with respect to u and equate that to 0. If the first derivative does not change with respect to, first derivative with respect to u does not change, that is dou eta by dou u equal to 0, when this condition is satisfied, that gives you the condition for maximum efficiency. So here if you substitute in terms of eta, dou by dou u of eta, this is the expression for eta equal to 0. Here we are considering the partial derivative with respect to u. So to find the partial derivative, first we can take the terms which are not in terms of u as constant and take them out, which are 2, 1 plus cos theta and v cube, which means that you can write this as 2 into 1 plus cos theta divided by v cube, then the remaining terms for the partial derivative. So into dou by dou u of u into v minus u whole square is equal to 0. So here u and v minus u are the two functions which are in terms of u. So there are two functions, u is the first function and the second function is v minus u. When you have two functions, product of two functions, you can find the partial derivative like the first function into the differential of the second plus the second function into the differential of the first. It's equal to 0. Therefore, this can be rewritten as, take the constant terms outside, 2 into 1 plus cos theta divided by v cube. Then let us go for the partial derivative. First function is u into partial derivative of the second function, partial derivative of v minus u whole square, dou by dou u of v minus u whole square. Dou by dou u of v minus u whole square is given by 2 times v minus u into the derivative of v minus u, which is minus 1. Then plus second function is v minus u whole square into derivative of the first function, that is derivative of u, dou u by dou u, which is equal to 1, and equate this to 0. That's what I have written here, this step. And in this case, this function can be 0 if this part is equal to 0 or this part is equal to 0. But you see this part, 2 into 1 plus cos theta divided by v cube is not equal to 0 unless and until cos theta is minus 1. So for all other cases, this will be a positive value. Therefore, this function can be 0 if this part is equal to 0, that is u into 2 times v minus u into minus 1 plus v minus u whole square is equal to 0. which you simplify further and you will get this expression that V is equal to 3U. That means the maximum efficiency can be attained if the velocity of the jet V is equal to 3 times the velocity of the vane, or if the velocity of the vane is equal to 1/3 of the velocity of the jet. When you know that the efficiency is maximum when V equal to 3U, what is this maximum value of efficiency? That can be obtained if you substitute V equal to 3U in the expression for efficiency. We know that efficiency is 2U into V minus U whole square into 1 plus cos theta divided by V cube. If you replace all the V terms with 3U, you will get the expression for the maximum efficiency. So, here the V is replaced with 3U, and if you simplify this further, you will get that the maximum efficiency for a given theta is given by 8 by 27 into 1 plus cos theta. For a given vane, when theta is fixed, theta is known to you, we know that the maximum efficiency can be attained when the jet velocity is 3 times the vane velocity, or the vane velocity is 1/3 of the jet velocity. In that case, the maximum efficiency that can be attained is 8 by 27 into 1 plus cos theta, where this maximum efficiency is a function of theta. Therefore, higher efficiencies can be attained by adjusting the value of theta. What will be the value of theta which can give you the maximum or the highest efficiency in case of a curved vane? The highest efficiency is possible when this cos theta attains the maximum value, and we know that the maximum value is 1, and that 1 is when theta is equal to 0. That means the highest efficiency can be obtained for a curved vane when theta equal to 0. And if you substitute for theta equal to 0, you can calculate that the maximum efficiency is 0.592 or 59.2%, which is slightly less than 60%. And when theta is 0 degree, we have already seen that that represents the case of a hemispherical vane. And for a curved vane, the maximum efficiency can be obtained if you maintain the shape as that of a hemisphere, which is practically not possible because of some limitations, and therefore we try to maintain the shape as close to the hemispherical shape as possible. Even in that case, if you are using a single vane which is moving with the velocity u is equal to 1/3 of v, the maximum efficiency that can be attained is slightly less than 60%. Thus, to summarize what we have seen so far, we have been discussing about the jet impact on a curved vane which is smooth and frictionless and is held symmetrical about the axis of the jet. And if the vane is stationary, the force exerted by the jet on the vane along the direction of the jet, Fx, is given by rho a b square into 1 plus cos theta, and force along the y direction, Fy, is 0. In this case, please keep in mind that since the vane is stationary, work done is equal to 0. But if the vane is moving with a velocity u, and we have seen only the case where u and v are in the same direction, in that case we need to consider the relative velocity with which the jet is striking the vane, and hence the force along the x direction is given by rho a into v minus u whole square into 1 plus cos theta, and Fy is equal to 0, where v minus u is the relative velocity with which the jet is striking the vane, and rho is the mass density of the fluid, a is the cross-sectional area of the jet, and theta is the vane angle, such that the jet is deflected through an angle 180 minus theta. And in this case also force along the y direction is 0, but in this case since the vane is moving with a velocity u, we can calculate the work done by the jet on the vane, and along the x direction the work done is given by Wx is equal to Fx into u, that is force multiplied by velocity of the vane in the x direction, that is given by rho a into v minus u whole square into 1 plus cos theta into u. This is the output power of developed by the jet, and input power is the input kinetic energy of the jet, which is half rho a v cube, which makes the expression for efficiency eta is equal to 2u into v minus u whole square into 1 plus cos theta divided by vq. We have also seen that this efficiency is maximum when the velocity of the wave u is equal to 1/3 of the velocity of the jet, and this will be maximum when theta is equal to 0 degree, and this maximum efficiency is slightly less than 60%. We will continue this discussion in the next lecture. Thank you.